Dr. Dolph Zillman began developing the excitation transfer theory in the early 1970s when he recognized the sympathetic nervous system often fools the central nervous system. Remember, our sympathetic nervous system is our 4F nervous system. It automatically and physiologically reacts to environmental stimuli that cause us to fight, flight, feed, or act sexually. While our central nervous system is our thinking and interpreting nervous system. It's composed of the brain and spinal cord. Zillman found sympathetic nervous system arousal can transfer to neutral stimuli within the environment. This transfer occurs via classical conditioning, and in specific circumstances is interpreted by the central nervous system as being sexual. Zillman and his colleagues found initial evidence for this transfer of sexual arousal with experimental participants who were required to be cycling for 10 minutes before viewing an erotic film. These participants with excited sympathetic nervous systems from cycling found the erotic films to be more sexually arousing than participants who were not cycling before viewing the films. Now let me be clear, cycling per se does not lead to sexual arousal. Instead, the key to this transfer of sexual arousal is amping up the sympathetic nervous system by any means before a potentially sexually arousing situation. Richard Dienstbier amped up the sympathetic nervous systems of his experimental participants by startling them. He did this by jerking back the seated participants' chairs 35 degrees from vertical and dropping a 4-pound weight on the ground. Following the startle, Dienstbier had an opposite sex experimenter enter the room in which the participants were seated. Dienstbier found participants with excited sympathetic nervous systems from the startle had greater sexual attraction towards the opposite sex experimenter than participants who had not been startled before meeting the experimenter. Gregory White and his colleagues amped up the sympathetic nervous systems of experimental participants by either negative or positive environmental situations. For some of his participants, he had them listen to a graphic audio recording of a mob killing. Some of his other participants listened to a humorous audio recording of a comedian give his stand-up routine. And a last group of participants listened to a monotone narrator describe a frog's circulatory system. Following these recordings, all participants viewed a film of an opposite sex person give a brief biography of themselves. Participants with excited sympathetic nervous systems from the graphic and humorous audio recordings rated the people introducing themselves as significantly more sexually attractive than participants who had listened to the recording about the frog's circulatory system. Donald Dutton and Arthur Aaron showed this transfer of sexual arousal goes beyond the laboratory setting. They had experimental participants either walk across a narrow suspension bridge that was more than 200 feet above roaring rapids. The bridge tended to wobble and sway and twist. Or they had experimental participants walk across a wide, low-to-the-ground bridge that was stable and immobile. After participants walked across the respective bridges, an experimenter gave them a brief survey and a phone number to call if they had any questions. Participants with excited sympathetic nervous systems from walking across the high, narrow, swaying bridge were almost 4 times as likely to call the opposite sex experimenter than participants who had walked across the bridge that was wide, low, solid, and immobile. And as Dutton and Aaron had predicted, these questions were less about the experiment itself and more personal about the experimenter. My favorite demonstration of excitation transfer was done by Cindy Meston and her colleagues at the University of Texas at Austin. Meston interviewed people before and after riding roller coasters at amusement parks. Meston found people who were riding with a romantic partner rated their partners as being more sexually attractive after riding the roller coaster than before riding it, theoretically because of their excited sympathetic nervous systems from riding the roller coaster. And Meston found people who were riding alone rated a photograph of an opposite sex individual as being more sexually attractive and as having higher levels of dating desirability after riding the roller coaster than before riding it.